Hello guys, in this video we'll see how to design the professional looking PCBs using EasyEda. So let's get started.
First open your browser and click on here EasyEda.com. And you will be redirected to the EasyEda website. Now we will design the PCB here, and you need to log in first. After logging in, you need to create a new project. Okay. Now go to new and go to project and give the name to your project. Then here, right, you can write the description here. Then you can save by clicking the OK. Now go to the folder and click new. And then click on semantic. First we'll create the semantic, and then we convert it into a PCB design. Here on left side you can see here all the points you have created now, and here you can find the basic components by which we can create the semantic. And here, after designing the schematic or PCB layers, you can find what are the components used and what are the nets used. And then here are the parts. You can get the components which you don't find here from the user contributed components. Now I need the TDA2822M IC. Now I will search for here. Okay, you found it here. Now click on it, and you can see here it is a schematic layout, and here the actual PCB base. Now we will place here. Okay, here this is a you can place, after selecting a particular component, you can place n number of times. If you want to remove this, click on the escape, which will unlocks the mouse pointer. So first I will firstly create the schematic so that we can go with the PCB design. You can rotate the components by pressing on spacebar. See how it is rotated. You can adjust like this. I needed someone's pin. Guys, now we successfully created the schematic of the circuit. Now we will go to this and save it as then save it. Okay, we successfully save. And now what we need to do is, now we will convert this schematic into PCB design. Now click here, you can see this convert project to PCB. After creating this, here you can see your components here. Now we need to place this component here within this box in such a way that the routing lines will be lesser and occupies the minimum space. Okay guys, now I successfully placed the components on the board. Now we need to reduce the space here. Now I click here and I will slide like this. You can see the PCB we have done, the placing is completed. Now we have to connect the components each other. Now what we need to do is, first we have to select the which on what side to route it. If you are using the surface mounted devices, you need to route on the top layer. You can see here, if you want to route it on the ground layer, you need to use through hole components. Through hole components means we drill the holes into the PCB and we will solder the components on the bottom side. So we need to route it on the bottom side and we will place components on the top layer. Now this is the through hole components, these are all through hole components. So I will select the bottom layer. See, here you can select the top layer or bottom layer. And now we need to route the components. So first click here, it will auto route the components, and you can select your requirement track width. I will select the 18 and general clearance I will select 10. Now you need to select only bottom layer. If you use through hole components, if you use SMD, you need to select the top layer. Now click on the run. The auto routing is started. It is successfully completed. So we will just adjust this component wires where there is a chance of short circuit. So now the routing is completed. You can add the text of the components or the top layer, your required text. Select. Okay. This will be on the top of the, so there is no problem. Now here the PCB design is completed. Now we need to save this. Now go to this and we'll save PCB, click on save. By this we completed the PCB design. Now the question is how to import this PCB design. Now here you can see G, which is the Gerber output, which is actually used to make the PCB etching process. Click on it and it gives the information that check the footprint, because we need to check it carefully, because after designing the PCB, if we go to the production, there is a lot of problem if we have any errors in this. So it gives the suggestion to check the DRC errors. Now where to check the DRC errors? Okay, we'll close this. And here design, you can see the what are the components user, your user, and what are the nets. And here you can see what are the errors. Here you can see track to pad. here. If we untick it, here this is rooted here, and you need to connect this here. So I will select the bottom layer and I will remove this. I'll click on the delete. So we removed that. Now click this tool and now click here. Okay, by this we adjusted the error. Then save this. After saving this, you cannot you will not see any DRC errors, so it is now fixed here. Now what we do is, now we saved that and click on the driver output and then click OK. Then it will create the output files for you. Here you can download the driver files. Okay, click on download, it will be downloaded to your PC. Okay, I open this. You can see the files here. If you want to see its design layout, now click your photo view. This is how your PCB looks like after the production. So if you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. We'll see you next time.